We know how to make the spectral decomposition of a matrix in theory. Let us try to do so in this explicit example. So, we have our matrix A. How do we find our spectral decomposition? First of all, we need an orthogonal diagonalization. So, we need the eigenvalues and eigenvectors, and we have to form orthogonal bases. That's the first step. And once we have that, we can rewrite our A as lambda 1, p1, plus lambda 2, p2. And lambda 3, p3. So then we have to find the p1, p2, and p3. Well, most work is actually to find an orthogonal diagonalization. We have done so in earlier examples, so I will just give the result here. A equals, should be q times g times q inverse, where q inverse equals q transpose. And in this case, we have eigenvalues 4, 1, and 1, so there you have your d. Your q looks a bit ugly, but that's because you have to normalize all columns. Orthogonal matrix has orthonormal columns, so they are orthogonal and have length 1. So those q's usually look a bit ugly. So, but once you have found this orthogonal diagonalization, it's quite straightforward to make the spectral decomposition. So what you have to do is compute the p1, p2 and p3, but pi equals qi times qi transpose. And you have Q1, Q2, and Q3 already. Those are the columns of your matrix Q. So your P1 equals Q1 times Q1 transpose. You can use, for example, row column rule. Here we have a bunch of rows, and here a bunch of columns. So 1 over square root of 3 times 1 over square root of 3 yields 1 over 3, also for all the other elements. So that gives you your first column of the product. And the second and third column is completely symmetric, so they are the same. So there you have your matrix P1. And then for P2, we do the same, row column rule again. So here a bunch of rows, here a bunch of columns. So minus 1 over square root of 2 times minus 1 over square root of 2 gives you a 1/2. 0 times minus 1 over square root of 2 gives you a 0. 1 over square root of 2 times minus 1 over square root of 2, a minus 1/2. There you go. Second column, of course, all zeros due to the zero over there. And the third column is the same as the first, apart from a sign. So there we are. There you have the P2. Then only what's left is P3. So we use the third column, U3 here. So you have your U3 times your U3 transpose. Now let's do the first column. Use again row column rule. First component gives you minus 1 over square root of 6 times minus 1 over square root of 6. So 1 over 6. 2 over square root of 6 times minus 1 over square root of 6. Minus 2 over 6 or minus 1 over 3. And then minus 1 over square root of 6 times minus 1 over square root of 6 gives you 1 over 6. So there is your first column. You can do the third and the second and third one yourself. There you have your P3, and once you have your P3, you can write down your spectral decomposition, because that's the first eigenvalue, which is a 4, times P1, plus the second eigenvalue, a 1, times your P2, plus the third eigenvalue, again a 1, times your P3. So that's what your spectral decomposition looks like of your matrix A.